31, let's take a look at example 5. So it says a population of fruit flies is growing in such a way that each generation is 1.75 times as large as the last generation. Suppose that there are 250 insects in the first generation. How many would there be in the sixth generation? Okay, so if we want to look at this through the lens of a geometric sequence, I can hear 1.75 times as large as the last generation. So when you multiply a number, right, if you multiply this term by this common ratio, 1.75, you can start to hear that this is geometric, because I will take this number and multiply it by 1.75 to see how many insects are in the second generation, and then multiply it by 1.75 to see how many are in the third generation. And I have to go to the sixth generation. So I could read this as, well, it's a geometric sequence, and I'm starting at 250, and my common ratio is 1.75. But if you're thinking, hey, is this exponential growth? Because we talked about how when you have exponential growth, your population is a multiple of a term that came before it, right? And that's completely correct. This is exponential growth. It's growth because this would be our base of 1.75, and it's a number larger than 1. So really, this insect population is growing at 75% of its previous population. This is absolutely exponential growth. So geometric sequences are completely related to exponential growth in the same way that arithmetic sequences are completely related to linear growth. All right, but with this, they're asking you for a sub 6. All right, now because this is a geometric sequence, we are looking at the formula a sub n equaling a sub 1 times r to the n minus 1. And we would like a sub 6. Okay, so a sub 6 is going to be equal to a sub 1 times r to the 6 minus 1. All right, let's see what we have here. All right, let me separate that. That's our given. All right, so we have a sub 1 being 250 times r to the 5th power. All right, and then let's just crunch this number and see what we have. So this is 250 times 1.75 to the 5th. So we have, what, 4103.27? So I've got 4103.27. So basically I'm looking at about 4103 insects. All right, so by the time the sixth generation is rolling around, this population of insects has really grown, right? It's grown from 250 to 4103. Now I wanna just compare and contrast that with our exponential growth model, right? Do we remember the good old formula, a times b to the x? Well, a is always our starting value, and b is our base, right? And basically, they are asking me for, oops, this is f of x. They're asking me for f of technically 5, because our starting value is 250, and then we want 5 generations after that. So it's slightly different. We have to be aware that they want f of 5 here, because this is our starting value, and then each exponent is a multiple of our previous term of 250. But that would still get us to about 4103 insects. All right, so again, it's 5 because that's our starting point, and we want to go 5 generations past our starting point. Oh, this is funny. We're talking about insects. I don't know if you can see this little bug. It actually is. That's too funny. Maybe it's not funny to you. I think it's hilarious that we're talking about insects. Hold on, I'm gonna get this guy. Blah. Ooh, gross. Okay, well, maybe it was a fruit fly. Who knows? That's super appropriate though. Anywho, what I'm trying to say here is, if you want the sixth generation in a geometric sequence, go ahead, use that formula. If we were using exponential growth, we want 5 generations later, and that's what the exponent represents in here. So just slightly different ways of representing the same information. All right, so with that, we've taken a look at our geometric sequence formula, our explicit formula, and now we're gonna switch gears and move over to the recursive version. All right, I'll see you in a few, bye.